For estimation of saccharin, we need ammonium chloride salt, we need diethyl ether, we need Nestler's reagent, we need distilled water. This is our sample, juice sample. These are the glassware we will be using. And this is a separating funnel. We have to measure 10 ml of sample. 2 ml of HCl we have to add to the sample. Have to extract using 25 ml diethyl ether. So first we have to add acidified sample into the separating funnel. 25 ml of diethyl ether is added, then it is mixed well to facilitate the extraction. So whatever saccharin present would have got extracted into our diethyl ether. We have to remove the colored sample, so that is not needed now. Only diethyl ether portion we need for saccharin estimation, that we have to collect. The extracted ether should be heated over the hot plate to dryness. It is completely heated now. It is completely dry now. So we have to add 6 ml of HCl and 5 ml of water to this dried extract. So 6 ml acid has been added. 5 ml water is being measured and will be added. We have to mix it well and again heat it over the hot plate. We have to evaporate everything. At the last, only about 1 ml remains. So this is about 1 ml solution which remains. We have to make it up to the 50 ml using water. So water has to be added, mixed well. And we need to make it up to 50 ml. So now the volume has been made up to 50 ml with the dried extract. So our sample is ready now. We have to prepare a standard solution of saccharin as well. So the stock solution is of 200 ppm. Or about maybe less than that. From that, like, we will take different volumes of the stock solution and dilute it to obtain like linear concentrations. From the stock solution prepared, we are taking 0.5, 1, 1.5, 2 and 2.5 ml portions. Into volumetric flask or a beaker. So sample we are taking 2 ml. Blank is the plain water. We have to make it up to 25 ml. The all the both the stock as well as the sample, every beaker or every SMF, every conical flask, volumetric flask, whatever we have to make it up to 25 ml. After adding, so we have to add Nestle's reagent. About 1 ml of Nestle's reagent is added to every flask. Nestle's reagent should be added even to the blank and the sample as well, apart from our stock or standard solutions. About 1 ml of the Nestle's reagent is being added to every flask we had. So we have to allow it for mixing and we have to incubate it for the color development. So after incubation, this sample which was